What's up, YouTube? It's a pretty early Sunday morning. I'm here at the F1 racing track in Montreal. It's been known maybe for Gilles Villeneuve, Jacques Villeneuve drivers, Canadian ones. These are the new paddocks. So they did rebuild the whole building. They just did improve it a little bit, I think. You will have seats right there at the top. Obviously, right now it's winter time, but in summertime. And you have these garages, I guess, where all the teams are going to put their cars, parts, whatever. And usually you have access to garages here when they are in between the session. I think, I've never been, but I think you can just walk through the cars and perhaps you need to pay some extra money. But it's interesting because it's very, if you want, user-friendly. It's very nearby the track and very accessible. So let me just drive the track and down the track. And it's the speed is limited. Don't expect me to race anything here. There's none, no person, no marmot, because this is a park. There are marmots here in summertime. So there's no bicycle. However, when you are coming here in summertime, there's going to be, I believe, bicycles on the left side, kids, adults, families, cars on the right side. So please pay attention, never do anything stupid and make your stops. And so I'm perhaps going to skip stops now because, like I said, there's no one here. Maybe I could see perhaps another car, but it's safe. Also, so this is the start line. You see the perhaps the yellow lines. This is where the cars are aligned. So this is one of the yellow lines. Here goes. I'm not sure which one is the pole start, but it's around this place. Now this track, it's completely free to access with your car, with your bicycle, with your rollerblades, whatever else. And you have access by the island of St. Helena. I'll show you in a moment, but it's better to get a map or something like this. And it's completely free. It's always open. I believe it's like it's 8 o'clock in the morning, weekend, and it's open. So it's access is perfect. Winter time, summer time. Again, it is not, and it's never going to be a Nürburgring or something like that where you can just pay a ticket and come race. It's not for racing for the public. It's just to have a small drive. Hopefully people are going to keep it safe, because if a day someone is going to do some crazy thing here and hit a bicycle or so, they will, I know the Quebecers, they are going to close the track to the public. So be safe, be respectful. You can see these are the left lines for the bicycles. There's no bike in the winter time. Okay, so I'm driving you. The speed is limited to 30, that's kilometers per hour, about 20 mph. I'm driving slightly faster, maybe at 30 mph right now, because there's absolutely no one. The surface is smooth but not perfect, and it's still interesting to see. You see those guards on the sides. Let me just maybe talk a little bit. So these are a few chicanes. This is a slower portion of the track. In summertime, you absolutely need to do these stops. Absolutely, because you'll have people, kids crossing with the bicycle. The visibility is not good. It's crucial to be safe here. This is a building which was from the Expo 60, what was that, 67 or so. We have Saint Laurent River, we have the downtown of Montreal right there. I could pause a little bit and zoom in for you. See, this is the main area of downtown city, and you have the Saint Laurent River here. It's a park, and half of this park was it was already existed, half of the park, but the other half of it, the surface of it, was made in 60 whatever exposition, international exposition, was made with all the on the ground that was dug from the Montreal subway network. So they built the subway at the same time, all the digging into the ground, that ground they transported by truck on this island, which was already existing but much smaller, and they extended the island by, I don't know, 60% or more. So I don't know which portion exactly was built at that time of the island, but pretty sure, I think with the whole track perhaps, also it's man-built, if you want, island thing. Now this is one of the very few buildings that remain from that exposition, and you can rent, actually, if you have a wedding or so, you can rent here. I actually been here once. It's a very nice area of the park. Much less known by the population. You see these trees, they were planting various types of trees for the exposition. It's a very, very nice area to have a walk with your bicycle, dog, whatever. It's very bicycle friendly here. We also have the casino, which is now closed. Okay. Access is a little bit, well, I think it's tricky for people who came here for the first time, so by all means, check a map. There are maps of the island, maps on Google, so be sure to check a map. I'm not sure that the GPS will work. This is the exit, and you need to take a bridge. I will just cross the river. That's one of the exits here. Passing under the bridge. This is a very tight chicane. I believe the car will slow down here a lot. You have these bumps on the sides, the red ones. Again, be very, very careful with these stops. Don't skip them in summertime. Very important. This is again a long stretch, a curved stretch. I'm not sure what the speeds are here, but pretty high because it's pretty long. Like I said, there's also marmots here in summertime, but they are going to get a little bit into the hiding when there's a racing. And this is a U-turn right there. We don't have access to it in those sitting areas, but usually the cars will go there and make a 180 U-turn. And this is the access bridge. So you came here to this truck. By this bridge you have the big sphere, which is also from the Expo 67. There's an exposition inside, like with the river or something. Is really not interesting, but the sphere, it's interesting to just have a walk around and maybe check the marmots or so. That's the bridge we access here. You need to, again, use a map or so, it's so you don't get too confused. There's not many indicators. Quebecers are not very good with indicating touristic attractions, especially not in English. So you have a seating area, and this is one of the stretches where I guess also the cars will get really at speed here. And you have a kayak canal on the sides for was built for the Olympics. Also an area you may want to have a walk and visit. You have access by this place right here. So there's a long canal over there. You can notice perhaps this is a really long stretch here. They must be reaching somewhere close to maybe 200 miles per hour here, and it's right in front of the paddocks, and then is a pretty brutal braking, and that's the casino right on the right side, the only casino in Montreal. It's owned by the government. It's just another form to get taxes. I did went around the casino but never been inside, and I'm not a big fan to spend my money to just really enjoy and have that experience. The building looks nice from the outside. An And again, access is pretty tricky. You need to get check maps. We have a small lake here, and there is a beach. One of the, I think it's the only beach in Montreal. The water, it's definitely not something to swim in. The sand, it's almost acceptable. It's mostly fun for kids, but there's also young people here. And again, we got back to the palace.